Hi children, good morning. How are you all? You are all safe at home, I think. Today we are going to learn English. I am your Bharati teacher. I am here to teach you the English subject. So today we are going to learn a lesson. The children, do you know that plants are of different types? They may be short shrubs, medicinal plants, and some creepers are also there. So today we are learning about a boy named called Jack and the beanstalk. Beanstalk means the stem of a plant. The beanstalk means the stem of a bean plant. The name of the lesson in the first semester 1 is the first lesson, Jack and the beanstalk. Jack and the beanstalk. We'll know the meaning of beanstalk. Beanstalk means the stem of a bean plant. Stem, you know what is stem. So it grows into very high. The creeper will go up very long. Here, Jack and the beanstalk. We can. Today we are going to learn about what is going to be happened between Jack and the beanstalk. What is the speciality actually? So let's see. Here, children, open your English semester 1 textbook. Open page number 5. Here you can see the first unit, Jack and the beanstalk. I already told you what is beanstalk. Beanstalk is the stem of a plant. Here you can see a good picturization is there. In this you can see the characters. A mother, Jack's mother is there, Jack, and you may see other person also here. And here they have a cow also. In this story, we are going to learn how they are going to be. See here, in this first picture, we can see Jack, his mother, and cow. Here in this paragraph, Jack has a cow and it is the only source of their income. They used to earn money with the help of the cow. Cow, what the cow gives? Cow gives us, gives milk. That cow, whatever the cow gives the milk, it is going to be sell in the market and they used to earn money. One day, what happened? This cow, Milky, its name is Milky. Their cow, Milky, it stopped giving milk. So they are very worried about it. So if the cow doesn't give the milk, what happened? They will not get enough money to earn. So his mother, Jack's mother, decided to sell that cow in the market. So she told her son Jack to sell that cow in the market. So he took the cow to the market, and while he is going to the market, he thought, oh, our cow, we are going to sell it. We are going to sell this cow. And now, after selling this cow, how much money I will get? Oh, whatever it may be, how much money I'll get, for with that money we are going to start up a new business. He is thinking like that and going to the market. On the way, here you can see in the third picture, on the way he met with an stranger. The stranger, he said that to the boy that, oh lad, why are you taking this? Where are you taking this cow? The boy replied that I am taking this cow to the market for selling it. The stranger said, okay, I am going to buy this. He said in this, Here, the stranger, he accepted to purchase it. You know, purchasing? To getting it. So, stranger accepted to purchase it. For that, the stranger said, I am going to give you 5 beans. Five beans? What can I do with the beans? The boy replied. The stranger said, oh, these are the magical beans what I am giving to you. 5 magical beans I am giving. You soak them and you can see what the magic is going to be. Taking that very happily, he felt very happily, Jack. And he took the beans and he went back to his home. Up to here, it is there in this first page. Children, now open the next page, page 6. Here you can see, in the fifth paragraph, the boy, he sold the cow to the 5 beans and he bought that 5 beans to the home. Now the boy gave to his mother. His mother was very angry. Why she is angry? Because a cow worth of much money and this boy sold that cow for 5 pebbles. And now she is very angry and she is scolding the Jack. Jack felt very bad and he went to sleep that night. And her mother, she took that beans and she threw that beans out of the window. She thrown out of the window. The boy went to sleep and the next day when he woke up in the morning, when he looked out from his window, he could see a big creeper which is very long and it is reached to above the clouds. Here in this seventh picture, you can see the boy, when he came out of the window, when he saw the creeper going up very high into the clouds, above the clouds, now he was very shocked and he curiously want to know up to where the creeper went to. So he started climbing up the creeper. He climbed above the clouds. There he reached to a castle. Here we'll know what is a castle. What is a castle? Castle means palace. Castle means palace. You know that palace is nothing but a huge building. There we can see number of big rooms and with good furniture, very big palace, right? So he reached to big palace here. When he is about to enter the palace, he could smell something good to eat. So he quickly went into the castle and there near the table he could find a pie. Pie in the sense, you know, bread, a bread piece, like a sandwich. A pie he could see. So he quickly went near to the table and he ate that pie. Suddenly, in that castle, a lady enters. That lady is none other than Ogress. Now you have to know here, who is Ogre? Ogre. Ogre means... Ogre means giant. Giant means, you already know who is called giant. A huge man. Giant is huge man, and this giant is very bad. The giant is very bad, but her wife Ogress is very innocent and she is very kind. Looking at that boy sitting near the table and having that pie, she offered some more breakfast to eat him and she said, eat it fast, otherwise Ogre will come and he will eat you up. Ogre likes the kids a lot and he will never leave you. Meanwhile, ogress, he heard the ogre coming to that room. So quickly, ogress, what she did? She took the boy and she kicked behind the truck. Now the ogre entered into the dining hall. Here, up to here, it is there. In the next page, page 7, if you see here, the boy, the ogress, she hit the boy behind the truck. Now ogre enters into the hall and he shouted at his wife that, "I am feeling hungry, give me breakfast," he said. So that ogress, she offered breakfast to the ogre, and ogre was very disappointed with the breakfast, and he said, "The breakfast was pathetic and I am not happy with the breakfast what you have offered to me, and I am very angry now. Now if you don't give me the hen which lays the golden eggs, then I'll be very angry on you." Oh, the ogress, she listened to the ogre, and she went inside and she brought the hen which lays the golden eggs. Here you can see in the picture, he shouted at that ogre and that ogress, she brought the hen here. And here from backside, if you see the boy, who is that boy? Jack. He is observing everything what is going here. And ogre, he said, "Oh, a hen, if you don't give me the golden eggs, then I am going to eat you." Ha 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 ha. He said that he asked the hen to give more golden eggs. That was all, everything was observed by Jack. Here in this next picture, ogre said, "Hey," all the eggs he counted and he went back to sleep. After a few minutes, when he went to sleep, ogress, what she did? The boy was hiding behind the truck. He brought that. He called the boy and they both, and he asked the Jack to go down. When they are about to getting down, the ogre, he woke up and he shouted at them, the boy in a hurry, and he wants to escape from that castle. He wants to go down. They both, now here you can see, he shouted at ogress that, "Hiding the boy from me, I will have both for supper," he said. Even for ogress and the boy, that he was very angry and he wants to have both of them for his supper. So hearing that, they were very tense, and now on hearing that, they both came down by climbing down. Here you can see they are both climbing down. When he is coming out of that castle, this Jack, what he did, he quickly grabbed the hen which lays the golden eggs, and he came down running with this hen along with him. He quickly came down. Here you can see behind him, after him, ogress also, unknowingly she came down up to here. Open next page, page 8. Now here you can see, when they are both coming down, so ogre is also ready to come down along with them, and he is getting down after them in a hurry. Jack and ogress, they came down, and Jack has an idea. And he took the axe, you know, axe for cutting down the plants. He took the axe quickly and he cut down the creeper. Now the both came down. After that, the ogress, he fell down to the ground and he burned into smoke. Now here, now this Aughri unknowingly she came down. Now she is thinking that, now where should I go? I left from that castle. Now where should I leave? Now Jack said, oh, don't get worried. My mother will become a good friend to you and she will serve you best. And you can stay with us. Jack said, oh, on listening that, mother also said, okay, no problem, you can stay with us. But his Jack's mother said that you have stolen that hen from the castle. So what about that? So Aughri said, no, it is not stolen, just I have given. It is a reward from me that for releasing me from the castle. So she said, okay. And finally, they were very happy with that hen. What can they do with the hen? Because it is a golden egg laying hen. So they kept with them and they became very rich after that. Up to here, this is the lesson. And when you see in the next page 9, you can go with this exercises. You have the meanings here. See, bean stack, the stem of a bean plant. Here navy, here navy means, who is navy? Navy is innocent boy. Who is innocent boy? Jack was the innocent boy, no? Because of that innocentness, he took the beans from the stranger. Here you can go with this. And here when you see up in page number 9, learn new words. Learn words is there. Here already you people know what are opposite words. Try to write the opposite word for the underline word. Here Jack and his mother were very poor. So here you can see for the word poor there is an underline. So what is the opposite for poor? So you have to write down here. So like this, complete this exercise here. When you open the next page, page 10, see here, be bid. So already you people know. So what are the different word is there in the given words? You have to identify it. See here, read the following set of words carefully. Underline the word that does not fit it in. One has been done for you. I will show you the example. Here for the page 10, bibit, I'll give you example. See here. Suppose I am writing here. Rose, carrot, lily, lotus. So what is the different word here? Right. This is the different word. Why? Because these are the flowers, flower names, and this is a vegetable name. Like that you have to find out the differentiation in bibit and underline for that word. Okay, we'll continue our next class in the next session. Thank you very much. Bye children, and be safe. Thank you.